Namaskar, hello and welcome to NCRT's live phone-in program. My name is Tanvi Khurana and here I am with another session of social science titled Agriculture. And this is the second part of the same topic. If you haven't seen the first part, I would request you to please go to our YouTube channel NCERT Official. Watch the first part because these two topics are connected. And of course, we'll sum up the part one and give you a brief introduction of what exactly our expert explained to you in the first part, but rest will be in this part. So if you have any questions of agriculture, about millets, about fibers, about the industries, anything at all, you can always send it your questions through our email ID, which is dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. This is our email ID. It's already on your screen, so please note it down very carefully. All the 10th class students, this session is for you. Let's meet our expert. She is with us, Mrs. Sunita Bajpai. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Tanvi.
Ma'am, ma'am, I'll just give a very brief introduction of you to our viewers and then we'll begin. So, ma'am is a PGT in geography from KV number 1, AFS, Sector 14, Gurugram. And let's begin with the first question. And before the first question, I would request her to sum up the first part in just 2-3 lines and then we'll go ahead with the second part. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah, namaskar, everyone. In our previous session, we have discussed about what agriculture is, what are the various types of agriculture, the cropping pattern, the kharif, rabi and the zayat crops. Today we'll be discussing about the major crops of India.
Okay, so shall we start with the major crops, ma'am?
Yes, please.
What are the major crops of India, and could you show some presentation to our students for more understanding here?
Yes. So here on the screen, we have a table showing the major crops of India. The crops can be grouped under the four categories. The food grains, these are the grains which are used for human consumption. Example, rice, wheat. Commercial crops, these are grown for sale either in a raw form or in a semi-processed form like cotton and jute. Plantation crops, they are grown on a plantation covering a large estate like tea, coffee, coconut, rubber. Horticultural crops are the fruits and vegetables which are grown. So these are the four categories of the major crops grown in India.
Okay, ma'am, can you name a few important millets?
Yes. Now, the few important millets, mainly we will talk about jowar, bajra and the ragi. See, these millets, they have a high nutritional value. Like ragi, it is very rich in iron. Now, once we talk about jowar, it is the third most important food crop after rice and wheat. We'll be discussing about rice and wheat. These are the most important food crops. But jowar, it is the third important food crop after rice and wheat with respect to area and production. Maharashtra is the largest producer of jowar. Now, bajra, it is grown on the sandy soil. Rajasthan is the largest producer. Ragi, it is grown in a dry region in the red, black and sandy soil. And Karnataka is the largest producer of ragi.
Okay.
So now we will come to two most important food crops, is the food grains, that is rice and wheat. First, we will talk about rice. Rice, it is a staple crop for most of the Indians living in the southern states. As you know that India It is the second largest producer after China. Now, rice is grown as a kharif crop. In our previous session, we have discussed about the kharif crops. Again, I will remind you that kharif crops are those which are grown between the months June to September, that is during the rainy season. So this crop rice, it requires above 100 centimeters of rainfall and the temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Now the areas where rainfall is less, it is also grown with the help of irrigation. Here on the screen, we have the distribution of rice shown on the map of India. Now this, the dark color is showing the major rice growing areas, whereas the pink color shows the minor areas. Now these major areas, they cover the eastern part of UP, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, the deltaic region, the coastal areas, and the Indo-Gangetic plain. Whereas rice is grown with the help of irrigation in Punjab, Haryana, northern part of Rajasthan, and the western part of UP. As we have already learned that rice requires more water, that is more amount of rainfall. Now next, coming to wheat. Now when we talk about wheat, we can say it is the most important staple food crop in the northern part of India. It is a rabi crop. Again, I'll remind you, rabi crops are those which require less amount of rainfall and they are grown between September to December. They require poop growing season and they require bright sunshine when the crop is ripening. So 50 to 75 centimeters of rainfall. There are two major wheat growing zones, that is the Ganga Satluj Plains and the black soil region of the Dakhan, that is the southern part of India. Now here on the screen, we have the map showing the distribution of wheat. Now this is very important from the board of point of view, as they sometimes ask you to mark the wheat or the rice growing area, that is the major areas where these crops are grown. Now to talk about wheat, wheat is grown in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. These are the major areas. Whereas it is also grown in the eastern part of UP, Bihar, the eastern part of Rajasthan, Gujarat and the western part of Madhya Pradesh. So these were the two most important staple food crops of southern and northern states of India. So when you are learning for your board exams, you can make such type of table as it appears on the screen. You can make a tabular form, write the crop, the climatic conditions required, the growing states and the production. So this way it will be easy for you to remember the temperature requirement, the rainfall and the growing areas of a particular crop. Now next we will talk about pulses. Now when we talk about the pulses, we know that India is the largest producer as well as the consumer of pulses in the world. Pulses, they are the major source of protein for the vegetarian diet. Now most of the Indians are vegetarians, so we use pulses to fulfill our protein requirement for our body. Now to name some of the pulses, tur, udad, moong, masoor, peas and gram. These pulses, they require less moisture for their growth, so they can be grown even in the dry conditions. Pulses are the leguminous crops, that is, they will help in restoring soil fertility by fixing nitrogen from the air. In this way, the soil is made fertile again when we grow pulses. So pulses are grown in rotation with other crops in order to regain the fertility, that is for nitrogen fixation. Pulses are well grown in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, and Karnataka. Now, next about sugarcane. Sugarcane, it is a tropical as well as a subtropical crop. Hot and humid climatic conditions are required, like the temperature of 21 to 27 degrees Celsius and the rainfall varying between 75 to 100 centimeter. It requires low rainfall, but in few areas it is also grown with the help of irrigation. It can be grown on the variety of soils. Manual labor is very important for growing sugarcane, as from sowing to harvesting, manual labor is required. Now, India is the second largest producer of sugarcane, first being Brazil. Now, sugarcane, it is a source of sugar, gur, khansari, and molasses. You must be wondering what molasses is. It is a dark colored syrup. It's a juice which is obtained while refining sugarcane. So, sugarcane growing areas are UP, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, western part of Bihar, Gujarat. Here on the map, you can see that sugarcane is grown in northern as well as southern states of India.
Ma'am, why are these sugar industries mostly in South India? Is there any particular reason behind it?
Yes. Now, you can see in the map that sugarcane is grown in northern as well as in southern part of India.
Okay.
But a very good question, that why industries are in southern part, why not in the northern part? The reason is the southern part of India has comparatively less temperature when compared to northern part of India. So the industries are located closer to the sugarcane fields so that less amount of juicy content is lost while transportation. And the climatic conditions are also favorable in southern part. So most of the industries are located in the southern part of India.
Okay.
Yeah. So next we will talk about the oil seeds. Now, India is the largest producer of oil seeds in the world. Nearly 12% of the total cropped area is under oil seeds. Now, to name a few oil seeds, groundnut, mustard, coconut, soybean, sunflower are the oil seeds. Now, most of these oil seeds, they are edible. They are also used in a raw form. As a raw material, they are used in the production of soap, cosmetics, and ointment.
Ma'am, what is the use of oil seeds? How do we use these seeds?
See, the oil seeds, the oil is extracted from these seeds and the oil is used for various purposes.
Okay.
Like, the oil is used in the manufacturing of soap. It is also used in cosmetics, which mostly the ladies use. It is also used for the medicinal purposes in ointment.
Okay.
So next we will talk about the groundnut. Groundnut is the most important oil seeds produced in India. It is grown as a kharif crop. Andhra Pradesh is the largest producer of groundnut. Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Gujarat, and Maharashtra also grow linseed and mustard. Whereas sesame is used and it is grown as a kharif crop in northern part of India and as a rabi in southern part of India. Now here we have a map showing the distribution of groundnut on your screen. So you can see that this dark color, these are the major groundnut growing areas. See, groundnut is mostly grown in the areas with black soil. So the southern part or the Dakhan region has the main concentration of black soil. So this is the reason why groundnut is grown in peninsular India when compared to northern part. Now we will talk about the two most important beverages. Now beverages are the crops which are used for drinking, like the tea and coffee. See, India is famous for growing tea. It is a plantation crop, plantation agriculture. In India, it was introduced by British. See, Britishers found that the northeastern part of India, especially Sikkim and Darjeeling, they had very good climatic conditions for the growth of tea. And they also had the slight undulating hill. So this crop, it requires frequent showers throughout the year, which is good for growing of tender leaves. But the water should not stay in the roots of these tea plants. It has to drain out. So it requires a well-drained soil, which was very much present in the northeastern part of India. It is a labor-intensive crop, so cheap and skilled labor is employed in the tea gardens. Assam, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Andhra Pradesh, and Tripura, they are the major producers of tea in India. India is also an exporter of tea. It is a producer as well as exporter of tea. Now coming to coffee, now India produces 4% of world's coffee, and a very good quality of coffee is produced in India. Now do you know that Arabica, which was brought from Yemen, it is a country to the south of Saudi Arabia, it is a Middle East country, and this Arabica, it is in demand throughout the world. And India produces this good quality Arabica. Now this was introduced in the Baba Budan Hills. Baba Budan Hills, they are in Karnataka. So Karnataka, Nilgiri Hills, Kerala and Tamil Nadu are the major producers of coffee.
Okay.
Now here on the screen.
Ma'am, apart from Arabica, is there any other type of coffee produced in India?
See, India is a major producer of only Arabica.
Okay.
Indian coffee, it is exported and it is well known, famous throughout the world. Now, in the map, you can see that the eastern part of India grows tea, whereas the southern part of India, which includes Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu, these are the major producers of coffee.
Okay.
Now, next coming to rubber. Yes, I told you that rubber, it is also an example of a cash crop or a commercial crop. So it is an equatorial crop which is grown in the tropical as well as the subtropical areas with a moist and humid climate. That is, it requires more amount of rainfall, above 200 centimeters and the temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Rubber is also used as a raw material in the industry. India is the fifth world's natural rubber producer. So you must be keen in knowing which are the other producers in the world. So Thailand, Indonesia, Vietnam and China are the four other rubber producers in the world, India ranking fifth.
Okay, so rubber is basically produced by the Asian countries.
Yes.
Okay.
See, all these countries like Thailand, Indonesia, Vietnam, China, all these are Southeast Asian countries, and even India falls in it. So the climatic conditions here are very much suitable for the growth of
Rubber.
rubber,
Okay.
tropical and subtropical areas.
Okay. All right.
Now, coming to fiber crops, we'll be discussing about cotton and jute. India is a major producer of cotton, jute, and the natural silk. Now, first, we will talk about cotton. Now, India is the original home for cotton. It is well grown on the black soil. So, black soil is also called as the black cotton soil. This is the reason why it is named against this crop, as cotton is well grown on the black soil. Now, cotton also forms the raw material for industries like cotton textile industry. And India, it was the third largest producer, but when we refer to the recent data in your books, it is written third largest producer. But today, India is the first largest producer. We can say India is the largest producer of cotton in the world. Next comes China and then USA. So black cotton soil is very much favorable for its cultivation. It requires high temperature and less rainfall, nearly 210 frost-free days. And it requires bright sunshine. During ripening, there should not be rainfall. There should be bright sunshine for the cotton ball to blossom. It is a kharif crop and it requires 6 to 8 months for it to mature. So cotton, it is grown. See here on the map, we can see jute and cotton. Cotton, it is grown in Gujarat, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and even in Punjab, northern part of Rajasthan, and the western part of Haryana. Next, we will come to jute. Now, jute is also called as the golden fiber. It requires well-drained, fertile soil, high temperature during its growth. West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Orissa, they are the major producers of jute. Now, when we come to the uses of jute, gunny bags, mats, ropes, yarn, and carpet are produced out of it. But today you see that jute is not much in demand. The demand of the market value or the market demand of the crop jute is reducing because it is coming in competition with the synthetic fiber. Now, we people, we prefer synthetic fiber rather than jute. So this is one drawback of this golden fiber, that is jute. Next, coming to the horticultural crops, as I told you that they include the fruits and vegetables, and India, it is the largest producers of fruit and vegetables in the world. Tropical as well as the temperate fruits are produced in India. To name some of the fruits like mangoes, they are grown in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, UP and West Bengal. Oranges are very much famous in Nagpur and Cherrapunji. Bananas in Kerala, Mizoram, Tamil Nadu, and Maharashtra. Lychee and guava in UP and Bihar. Grapes in Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. So India produces 13% of world's vegetables also. To name few of the vegetables like cauliflower, cabbage, tomatoes, potatoes, and brinjal. These are the major vegetables produced in India. So these were the major crops. Now we will come to some of the problems of Indian agriculture. See, we can say that agriculture is the backbone of Indian economy. But Indian agriculture also has some problems, like the dependence on erratic monsoon. Erratic means that the monsoon is very irregular. Sometimes the rainfall is more, whereas in some years it is very scanty. In some areas the rainfall is, so area wise also the rainfall varies. So dependence on this erratic monsoon for the growth of crops by our farmers is a major problem. Next is the low productivity. As we know that India has very high and it is densely populated. So the production per person is low. Production per acre is high, but production per person is low due to high land-man ratio. That is the population and land ratio. It is very imbalanced. So the low productivity is another problem of Indian agriculture. Now, constraints of financial resources and indebtedness. Our Indian farmers, they are mostly illiterate. Majority of the farmers are illiterate, and in order, they are very poor also. So in order to grow the crops, in order to buy seeds, equipments for the cultivation, for irrigation, they need funds, finance. So they borrow it from money lenders, which pushes them into the indebtedness. Now, fourth important problem is the lack of land reforms. See, it is not actually the lack of land reforms, it is actually the lack of implementation of those land reforms. There are land reforms in India which have been introduced time to time, but they have not been properly implemented. Now, small farm size and fragmentation of land holdings. This is another problem. Now, fragmentation means the agricultural land is divided into smaller parts due to the hierarchy, and the father gives the land to his sons. So the land is divided, it is fragmented. So the smaller farms, the mechanization or commercialization cannot be practiced on the small size farms. So that is another problem. Lack of commercialization. Indian farmer mostly grows the crop for subsistence, that is for his own use. But in commercialization, we grow crops to earn the profit. So there is lack of commercialization. As the population is high, most of the crops, they are consumed in India itself due to high population. Okay. Next problem is the...
Ma'am, yes. We've got last 2 minutes left.
Yeah, I'll just sum up.
Okay.
So degradation of the cultivable land. The land, mostly you can find the change in the land pattern, land use pattern. Most of the land is now devoted to the building purpose, construction purposes, which is leading to the degradation of cultivable land, soil erosion, and inadequate storage facilities with the farmer, and crop residue burning are the major problem. You have heard about CRB. Now, when the farmer burns the crop, the soil also becomes infertile. So these are the major problems of our Indian agriculture.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this entire information regarding agriculture. It is very interesting, and everyone should know about agriculture and these details, what we eat, what we don't eat, what are produced in India, what is distributed in which states. This was very important information. Thank you so much for your time and for everything.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thank you to all the students for watching this entire session. And like I said, it was really interesting. Still, if you have any questions that you want to ask, you can always send it on our email ID and also on our YouTube channel, which is NCERT Official. So we always wait for these questions. Coming up next is a maths class where we are going to talk about probability. And this will be the third session of the same topic. So stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Keep on watching PM eVidya channels. Namaste.